Thank you very much for staying with us. Now let's settle down for the details of our story. So one person has been confirmed dead, whilst about 10 others sustained various degrees of injuries when a building they were working on collapsed Saturday night. Peter Carr Adato reports that the workers were casting the first floor concrete when the building gave in at about 11:30 p.m.
The construction work reportedly commenced a few months ago. Reports said the one-story building project is meant for a restaurant near the Akai House, Cantonment, Accra. The workers say they were in the process of casting the first floor concrete when the section gave in. 10 workers reportedly went down with a collapsed structure. Emergency and rescue workers, including the police, fire service, military, NADMU and ambulance service, all responded to distress call. From the time of the accident till 12 noon Sunday, 10 people, including 2 bystanders, were rescued and rushed to the police and 37 military hospitals. The last construction worker was pulled out dead under the debris with the aid of private construction firms, which made their services and equipment available.
And then we must also look at the health and safety law of this country, because if the health and safety law is there and it is being enforced, at any stage that a construction of this kind is going on, the safety engineer will be at the site and make sure that the best practice procedures are put in place so we don't have such disasters.
The police confirmed the casualty.
We made a follow-up to those who were sent to hospital, 37. All of them have been discharged now. At the police hospital, we are now left with 3 on admission, but we are told they are in a stable condition.
The project was said to have begun without approval from the La Dadikotopon Municipal Assembly.
And the rule is that whenever you are going to do any work, you have to inform the assembly. This time around, when they were going to cast this concrete, they didn't inform the assembly. But when the engineers came and they looked at it, preliminary assessments showed that it was the temporary support that gave way.
The police and fire service have meanwhile commenced investigations to unravel the cause of the disaster.
I was asking that what are your initial comments, you as in the assembly, the municipal assembly, what are your initial comments on the collapse of the building?
What you have observed is the collapse of a freshly cast institute concrete slab on the two-story building. They were constructing in the night on Saturday, 6 December. And then the slab collapsed. Yeah, but we at the assembly know about this development, which started. And then we stopped them on 1st September 2014 for them to stop work and then do the proper thing by applying for permit for approval. You know, and their documents were submitted when we asked them to stop. They stopped work, actually. That was on the 23rd September that they submitted their documents, which we studied. And then we visited the site again on the 20th October to see if they complied with our instructions to stop work. And then we passed the documentation to the technical subcommittee, which sat on the application. And then that was on the 22nd October 2014. And then the technical committee forwarded the application to the statutory planning committee, which approved the application on 2nd December 2014. Mm-hmm. And then subsequently, the approval was communicated to the developer on 3rd December 2014. And what we are seeing is that what happened on Saturday at night, and then it's around 11 p.m. that the incident happened. That was Saturday, 6th December 2014. We were not there. It was in the night. But we interviewed and we were informed that they were using ready-mixed concrete. That's the mobile concrete mixer. Was pouring concrete under pressure onto the decking. The decking was made up of steel and wood, which supports the formwork on which the concrete was being poured, fresh concrete. And from what we saw and believe was that there might be an insecure support or insufficient support to take the concrete, fresh concrete, which was being loaded.
Right.
And the support gave way and the whole thing fell.
Okay, you in your initial comment, you said that you asked them to stop work some time ago. What did you see that called for the municipal assembly to ask them to stop work? Was it because they were using substandard materials, or they didn't have the right permit to put up the structure?
They didn't have approval, that's why we stopped them. But the structure was sound. If the structure is not sound, we would demolish it and then you reconstruct. But the structure was sound, and we asked them to submit the documentation, which they did, with the drawings, approved drawings, which were submitted, and we went through the process. As I told you, from 1st September to 23rd September, 20th October, 22nd October, we had a meeting, to 2nd December, the approval was conveyed. The Faculty Planning Committee met and approved, and the approval was conveyed to them on 3rd December.
Okay.
So that process went through. Went through that process. We took them through the process.
So what would the Municipal Assembly's description of what happened on Saturday be? Would you call it an accident or an act of negligence?
Yeah, are you with me?
Yes, I'm with you. Can you hear me? Mr. Amedo, I'm asking that how would the Assembly describe what happened on Saturday? Would you say it was an act of negligence or it was purely an accident?
We were not there, but what we heard from them might be an accident. We were told one of the workers fell under, and in order to balance himself, held the prop, and it moved from his position with the other props around, and it created a weak point under the deck. And once there's a weak point, all that line of construction gave way.
Right.
So we see it as an accident in that way, in that vein.
Okay. But how did it happen that the Municipal Assembly was not aware that such a structure was being put up, and it had come up to a certain level before your authorities went in to ask them to stop work to secure permit?
No, we go around periodically, in the municipality to check for the development that was going on. That's why we saw them and stopped them.
But isn't it?
But what they were doing on Saturday, we were not aware, and they were working in the night too. We were not aware.
But is it the norm that people start putting up structures before they come for permits? Is that what happens?
Yeah, because of traffic during daytime, they decide to work in the night because of traffic. Because the mobile trucks that were called corporate had to use that road to cause inconvenience. So they work in the night. That's what we asked them, and they told us.
All right, Mr. Amedo, thank you very much. We'll have to leave it here for now, and I do not think he heard my last question, but thank you very much. He is the Municipal Works Director at the Ladadekotopo Municipal Assembly, and they were giving their position on the collapsed building around Cantonment that claimed one life and injured about 12 people.